engaged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers and three other young women along the route. Billy Jasper of Winslow, Arizona, claims he likely had an encounter with the assailant at his home over a year ago. Jasper says a young woman in her 20s approached his home seeking water and food, but after a few minutes, the woman allegedly became irate with Mr. Jasper's line of questioning. Eventually, the unidentified female started to attack Jasper with a razor blade. He was able to defend himself until the attacker eventually fled. Jasper's description of the female is consistent with multiple reports from New Mexico, Texas, and California, especially cities close to the I-40 corridor. Authorities are...
What I get for taking it easy on them. Damn it, Johnny. Get your head straight. Come on now. Don't worry. So soon.
Gotcha. You can't hide from me. I hear him. Over there.
This is pointless, you know. Quit stalling. Oh, you ain't getting away. I'm keeping you. I'll find you. Don't you worry about that. Don't worry. I'll find you.
Where the hell did those kids find us? Should be more careful.
Adolescent vandals have been terrorizing the city of Lexington, Texas, with horrific depictions of famine and the macabre. Nearby active officers may involve remote Odessa sheriffs investigating evidence authorities locally intercepted years ago. The grotesque animal dioramas, composed of fox bones, have appeared in the two cities, yet their connection is unknown, but not likely coincidental. The youths are believed to be sisters, but authorities cannot confirm nor deny potential lineage. Citizens are encouraged to report any findings to the police. The remains of an unidentified male have been discovered near Devil's River off Highway 163 in southwest Texas. A Cedar Canyon resident stumbled upon the scene while hunting early yesterday morning. Authorities have confirmed this is approximately the same location where two females were discovered last June. All of the victims appear to have been stabbed and strangled to death. Although the cases have similarities, investigators have nothing more to share at this time. The search continues in Muerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no sign. What should have been a night of memories and celebration turned into a scene one witness described as hell on earth. Teenagers at Dutton High School were celebrating an otherwise uneventful senior dance when two local men, identified as 43-year-old Hackett Wayford and his 24-year-old son, Rand Wayford, entered the gymnasium with a variety of bladed weapons and began attacking those inside. Six students, all members of the football team, managed to subdue the men before anyone was severely injured. Matthew Hickory, one of the boys responsible for ending the nightmare, told reporters that the two men were freak strong, like bulls or something. Authorities arrived and were able to arrest the men, who are now in custody. The man believed to be responsible for multiple stranglings in East Texas is finally in custody tonight. Authorities followed a tip that led them to a deserted motel outside Ryan.
Can't nobody do a job right but me around here. I tell you what, I'ma smack that Johnny upside his doggone head. This is all his doing.
What the heck is everybody doing? We should have found them by now.
Thank you. Wait till your mother hears about
this.
Grandpa
ain't gonna be too pleased if
she's gonna skin you alive.
Can't think straight with all this craziness going on. Thank you.
Pflugerville, Texas last year is back in the public spotlight. Pflugerville citizens are in an uproar demanding answers from Texas state officials on why no arrests have been made in the case. Reports say an unidentified man entered the home in the middle of the night, viciously strangling one female to death before attempting to stab both roommates who were sleeping nearby. Authorities believe the attacker fled the scene after discovering multiple people lived in the house. The man is believed to be in his late 20s, has dark hair and brown eyes, and has several scars on his face and arms. Police are urging anyone with information to please come forward. New details have emerged in the grisly string of murders that littered Interstate 40 during 1971 and 72. Known only as the Terror of I-40, authorities say an unidentified woman spent years hitchhiking from Texas to California, where she viciously murdered several truck drivers.
Don't be nervous. Sissy's gonna be right there with you.
Thank you.
Search continues in Huerto County for a missing University of Texas student. The sheriff's department says Maria Flores, a native of Uvalde, was last seen near the town of Newt. Her vehicle was recently discovered abandoned, with officials reporting no signs of foul play. Authorities are hopeful that the expanded search in the nearby communities of Harlow and Chinatown will unearth new leads. Family and friends are urging anyone with information regarding her disappearance to please come forward. What should have been a night of memories and celebration turned into a scene one witness described as hell on earth. Teenagers at Dutton High School were celebrating an otherwise uneventful...
kill someone.
Ugh.